Alrighty. So today we're going to increase the boredom factor of a flight simulator by including checklists. Because I'm supposed to, like, part of my private pilot's license is to know how to work checklists. And I've got, like, one in front of me here. It's, like, right here in my lap. You can't see it. Okay, here we go. We'll start with the cabin inspection. Boop. All right. Oh, wrong seat. Boop. There we go. Okay. Face this way. Certificate/document. Need to check that they're in the aircraft. I'm looking for an airworthiness certificate, a registration, an operating limitations, aircraft flight manual, and make sure that I did my weight and balance calculation. So, I don't see any. What's in here? Is it in here? No, it's just that guy. Shit. All right. Maybe in the seat back pocket? No. All right. So we'll pretend they're there. There's this thing, which is like markings and placards installed in this air, blah, blah, blah. It's okay, whatever. Next, parking brake set. Yes. Control wheel lock. I don't have one. Ignition switch off. Master switch on. Okay, if you say so. Fuel quantity indicators. Check quantity. About 14 and a half gallons on each wing. Cool. Anti-collision strobe lights. Check operation. So strobe, beacon. Okay, it's kind of light out, so maybe we can't see it. Oh, there's strobe. Yep. Bink. Okay, that one. Bink. Okay, good. Flaps down for inspection. You guys later. All right. Lights. Master switch off. Baggage door secure. Who gives a shit? Tail section. Let's inspect the tail. Now that's a fat ass. All right. Tail. Tail tie down. Rudder gust lock remove. Sure. That's done. Elevator and rudder check freedom and secure. I can't, because I can't interact with things with these silly hands. Okay, what's the last thing? Nav lights. Unbroken. Yes. It's not broken. Okay. Let's do the right wing. Oh, God. Too far. All right, so right wing. Flap, tracks, and actuator rod. Yeah, sure, they're fine. I think. Sure, I'll call that inspected. Oh, God, my head's in the flap. Aileron, check freedom and secure. Ooh, it's free and secure. Nav light unbroken, should be green. Oh, shit. This teleporter's lame. Look at that. It's green. Cool, and it's unbroken. Fuel quantity, fuel or cap. I can't interact with the fuel tank here, but I can kind of... No, I can't even get up there. Wait, I can do this. Hang on. Wait for it. There. Okay, so the fuel cap is fine over there, and it's okay over here, and I think that's cheating. Right wing, what's left? Fuel tank. Is it tied down? The tie down is not tied to the ground. Sure, everything on a checklist is because someone did something stupid, and that's a good dumb one. Main wheel tire, check wear and inflation, 29 PSI. Boop, boop, boop. Yes, fine, whatever. All right, so what's next on the list? The left wing, all of that shit, plus check the stall warning controller and the pilot. Okay, I can do that. So this is the pilot. That's where the air comes in, so you can see airspeed and other stuff. This is the stall indicator. The angle of attack is too great. This thing doesn't flap around, and then it beeps. And when the stall indicator beeps, according to my good friend, you get double points for any maneuvers you make while the beep is happening. And of course, landing light's fine. Nose! Noaz. There's my nose. So what's up on my nose here? Windshield. Check clean. Okay, that's clean. Wheel chocks removed. I don't think I have any. engine oil dipstick. Oh God, I don't have an engine. Whoa. Yeah, so I can't do any of the engine pretend things. Fuel strainer, nose wheel, check wear and inflation. Fine. No shock strut, check inflation. Approximately 3.25 inches showing. That's what she said. Yeah, that looks like 3.25 inches. That's what she said. Okay, propeller and spinner check. Oh, God. It is a propeller and spinner. I can't see myself in it. What's in there? Is there anything in there? No, nothing's in here. Okay. Air inlets free of foreign matter. That actually looks pretty cruddy. What the hell, X-Plane? Tow bar remove. Yes. Static port check. I can't check it. Okay, that's the pre-flight. Let's go to the before starting engine. Chocks, remove. Pre-flight inspection, I did that. Passenger briefing. You're not passengers. Here's my actual couch and real IRL couch. There it is. Okay. Ugh. Fix that. All right. pre-flight. Before starting engine. Chocks, yes. Pre-flight inspection. Passenger briefing. There's the door. There's the fire extinguisher. Here's all this shit. And in the event of accident, your seat becomes a toilet. Seat belts and harnesses. Fine. Brakes, test and set. I don't have actual pedals. I can't do anything with the brakes. But we'll just use the parking brake and everything's going to be fine. Circuit breakers. Test and set. Test. Okay, they're fine. Radios and electrical equipment off. Fuel selector, both. Both. Tow bar remove. How many times am I going to... Whatever. I'm sure that's the thing they screw up. All right. Let's go to starting the old engine. Mixture. Rich. Carburetor heat cold. Prime. Whatever. That feels really Mickey Mouse in a VR. Throttle open 1/8 of an inch. Master switch ONN. Anti-collision strobe lights. Check operation. Didn't I already check those? Whatever. I haven't turned them off, because that's what kind of person I am. I'll just turn all these other lights on for funsies and wear down the battery. Propeller area. Clear! Alright, you have to yell that out the window and be cool about it. Ignition switch, start! Okay, we'll need a new ignition system later on because of my stupidity there. Engine warm-up. Oil pressure check. 60 PSI. Engine warm-up. 812, 100 RPM. We're at 900 RPM, so it's fine. 750, but fine. Extreme for taxi. For taxi, lights and strobes as required. Radios on and set. Not really going anywhere, so whatever. I guess I could check the weather. Transponder on and set. Oh, transponder standby. Shit, the couch is in the way of my controller. There, okay. Standby. Flaps up. I would try to take off like that. Checklist. Holy shit. Seatbelt fine. Brakes test. Okay, we'll go to the run-up area and finish the checklist. parking before takeoff, like we said, seatbelts check secure, cabin doors and windows closed. Yes. Fuel selector both. Control surface is free and correct. Set for takeoff. Fuel quantity check. Have I lost fuel since I've... No, there's still the same fuel. Mixture rich. Mixture throttle 17 RPM and then check the mag wheels. Left magneto on. Lost RPM, so I know it's working. Right magneto on. Lost RPM, so I know it's working. Now got ruined still very well. That's enough of that. Forgot to check suction. Yep, ring green. Altitude and ammeter check. I should probably fix this at 24. Altimeter read because it's make believe or whatever. Cool ammeter. Jump back, bam. It's pretty steady, good. Throttle check idle limits. Fiction lock adjust. The radio set. Transponder altitude. Okay. As takeoff, which is on here, lights as desired, brakes release. Okay, for takeoff, we're going to leave our flaps up, we're going to have carburetor heater off, we're going to throttle full. Elevator control is going to move. We're going to lift the nose at 650 miles an hour and climb at 75 to 85. plate, it's for like part of the homeowners association there. You can still land on it, but you can't, like there's like a locked gate, and you literally can't do unless you are part of the HOA. So you can land there if you have no shed. But that's it.
Heat, that's done on Florida. medium high. Is it the land? They're only the pitch there? Or the... Oh, well, whatever. Southwest Florida International Information Sierra. Yeah. 2200 Zulu weather. Wind calm, visibility 10. Sky conditions 3400 view, 7000 broken, 10000 overcast. Temperature 26, dew point 24. Altimeter 2988. Arriving runway 34, departing runway 34. Advise on initial contact, you have Sierra.
Sierra. center, November, 06, X-ray, Papa.
West Florida.
Center, November, 04, X-ray, Papa.
looks as good as anywhere else to park. Paint job is tragic. Okay, well, that was fun.